Have you ever thought about starting your own podcast? When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions. How do I record an episode? How do I get my show into all the apps that people like to listen to? And how do I make money from my podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is so very easy and simple. It is Anchor, y'all. It's Anchor. Anchor is a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it is 100% and ridiculously easy to use. Most of all, it is free. And now, y'all, Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad here. I use Anchor for my radio broadcast as another branch to advertise and promote my episodes and my show that stems right from YouTube. And what I like about Anchor is that it distributes all to many platforms, as well as it has an in-depth statistics to where you can see how your podcast is doing. That's cool, right? I love it. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, please go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters who are already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. My name is Red, and I'm the host of the RH3 show. I cannot wait to hear your podcast. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, Father, for today's broadcast. Lord, I thank you, Father, for each and every one that is listening to me under the sound of my voice. Father, bless today's broadcast, Father, that it'll reach to the ears of those who want to seek to know more about the RH3 show, want to make the RH3 show grow, and want to know and have ideas to extend and to expand the RH3 show. Lord, we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praises. It is in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
And now we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Switch my old status, that's from sinner to saint. As winners, we can't live by the picture they paint. Because they know that all the inner is changed. So we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint. Which means, do I live and we ain't? We are controlled by the flesh, we're defeated in sway. And pray without a quitter's complaint. And being able to calm down your dinner at 8.
What's going on, everybody? This is your boy Red, and I am the host of the RH3 show. Welcome to another great broadcast, you all. I have a splitting headache. Sorry about Tuesday's broadcast, and probably today, I don't even know how it's doing now, but the system has been acting a little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs since last week, and I still go on live and record as I'm going, but if you should miss it, we always here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on the podcast platform. So if you will, by all means, search the RH3 show on any major podcast platforms. Y'all, we got a great show, jam-packed show on today. If I could do the whole broadcast, which I am probably about 90% sure that I'm not. But if not half, probably about 75% of it is going to be best of. Y'all, my head is just about to bust. I'm sorry. And I'm got my eyes closed now, looking at this screen. So please forgive me. Please forgive me. But coming up next, you guys, I ain't nothing been going on. There's no need for no chit-chat. But excuse me. I'm going to really get into that Kevin Hart conversation next with the Inside Scoop with Red. Then Nina gonna come. And then I'm going to speak on Fantasia and Kendall. And they were talking about, being submissive, in their relationship. And then I kind of agree with them. And, I do agree with them. But I want to add some more to it because we all missing a point here. We all missing a point. And so... Well, some of us missing a point. Not most of us. Not all of us. But some of us is missing a point. And so I just want to discuss more on that. And so that's it. And then I'll read a couple Ask Red letters and I'm getting up out of here. And then if we have a lot of time left, then majority of Tuesday's broadcast will air at the ending of today's. All right? Be back with more of the RTWR Show. All right? Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy, Ren, and I'm the host of the RTWR Show, and I'm back with another Be Positive moment of the Be Positive series. I'm going to pull this out of me, so hey, it is what it is. Let's continue to love, y'all. Love is it covers a multitude of sins, y'all. Love shows, you can express love in any kind of way by gifting, by words, by emotion, by physical touch or whatever. It's a lot of ways to show each other love. So what how do I show love to somebody and they're not receiving it, or when I show them or give them a gift they don't want it? We all have our own different type of love language, so try to cater to somebody's specific love language. Get to know them, get to know them and know what they like and what they don't like. And then that's how you can hone in and, try to focus on what they love. General people, love them with agape love. That's the God kind of love. And this one more love, I don't want to say it off gate, but because I don't know the exact, which one I'm thinking of. But just study your love languages. Show people love, and I bet you'll feel good about it, right? For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit my website at thearch3show.com. If you're not tuning into the RTWR Show weekly, here's what you've missed. But what I'm saying is, if you should seek a mate, if you should get married without seeking God, y'all both have to be on the same page to get things right with God. And then ask God to, this is my thing. If I should do that, I'll go to my pastor and say, "Pastor, I want you to guide us. I know I went out of order. I'm asking God to forgive me. I'm asking you as my spiritual leader to forgive me. I want, to seek counseling. I want to set up counseling sessions, 12 weeks or whatever, however you see fit. And then at the end of that, I want you to bless this marriage and pray for us. As a leader of my house, I'm willing to set things straight and to move forward." Come on, you all, join me live every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Or you can join me on the podcast anytime. For more about me, the broadcast, or the podcast platform, you can visit my website at thearch3show.com.
No, I'm not a writer.
Okay.
Want the latest news regarding the TV, movies, sports, politics, and music industry? It is time for the Inside Scoop with Red, right here on the RTWR Show. It is the Inside Scoop with Red segment, and this is where I give you my honest, my unscripted opinion on world and entertainment news. I want to say this And I don't really like doing this because it makes it seem like I'm all up in her tail, which I'm not. But earlier this week, I think it was Monday, Wendy was on, was it Monday? It was either Monday or Wednesday last week, one. Wendy, it had to be one day this week because Wendy came on. She premiered this week. And so, I think it was Monday. It was either Monday or was it Tuesday? It was Monday. I think it was Monday. She was talking about Christie Brinkley and her on Dancing with the Stars, and you know, she broke a shoulder and she sprained her wrist, and then she got up and whatever, she bowed out, and now her daughter's taking her place. And so Wendy said that, you know, she felt that it was a stunt or whatever, and she was you know faking it. And then another host on another show got on and was, you know, saying that Wendy was dark and mean and evil and this, that, and the third and whatever. But I kind of agree with Wendy. Why? It's because there are talk shows out here, talk shows, reality shows, competition shows that would do anything for ratings. That would do anything for ratings. And so, hey, Christie probably been the guinea pig for the rating boost. Christie probably been the guinea pig for those who, okay, we're going to spice this up. Do this, that, and the third. So maybe she probably did fake it. And there's nothing mean or dark about that conversation of what, you know, that statement of what Wendy said. Then Wendy got back on air, believe it was Tuesday, and apologized and said, hey, if I hurt your feelings, I'm sorry, but my opinion still stands. And that's how it is. If I feel that I'm, you know, my opinion, you know, if I feel that I believe whatever, whoop, whop, bop, bada, bop, on whatever, then if I known that I hurt your feelings, I'm going to apologize. But if I didn't, I'm going to keep on until you say, hey, you know, whatever, till you give a response. Then I'm going to go back and say, it was not my intentions to hurt your feelings, so I apologize. So that's what we got to do, y'all. When it comes to, you know, hurting folks' feelings, if we do not know we hurt folks' feelings until it's spoke of, until it's said, to something is said about it. All right? That's that, y'all. That is that. All right? That is that. But anyway, this Kevin Hart story, I'm almost done with it. I'm almost done with it. But as y'all know, that he was in a car accident. And, you know, I spoke on it a little bit last week. He was in a car accident. And, you know, allegedly he was drinking. And allegedly he was driving. And allegedly, you know, he only went home because to sober up, and, you know, a lot of things had come arise with him moving from place to place, him, you know, dealing with a major back issue, this, that, and the third. And so I'm going to play the 911 tapes, and I believe that, you know, for one, Kevin did his friends dirty for leaving them, and two, his wife is about sick of him. I don't know his state, his condition is as of now. I don't know, you know, whatever, but I felt that Kevin, you know, it was all wrong. But anyway, here is the 911 calls for, you know, from that whole ordeal or whatever, and I'll be back with more. All right.
Is everybody in the vehicle awake?
Yeah, they're both awake. Sounds like the passenger's stuck in the car. The driver is out of the car, but he looks a little hurt. I think the top of the car is crushed.
Okay, and how many vehicles involved total? Two.
No, it's just one car that went off. I'm here with another car that stopped to pull over. Pulled over to help.
Uh-huh.
Not this. So there's only one car that went off.
Okay. And everybody else is... Everybody is conscious and breathing. She is just the only one that's actually stuck inside the vehicle?
Yeah.
Is the vehicle overturned at all?
No, it's not. It's just off. It's just on the angle on the hill.
Okay.
I need a test. job it's out.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure they'll be able to do that.
Yeah, there's a few people in the car.
Yeah. There's two more in there?
Yeah. There's a driver and the passenger. I think the other person that's here was helping.
But how many are still stuck in the car?
Two are stuck in the car, so there's three, I guess.
Two, okay. Alright, are both of them conscious?
Yeah, they're all conscious.
Okay.
Help's coming, guys, don't worry. The ambulance is on the way. You guys okay in there? Stay calm, help's coming.
LA County Fire, number 6.
Hi, it was an accident. I just need to know who's on. I need someone to come get him.
Thank you. And he's at a house, apartment, or business right now?
Yes, he's in a house.
In a house. Okay, in the good. And you wait?
Yes.
Okay, and so he was in a car accident earlier tonight, or what happened?
Yes, earlier tonight. I don't know what happened.
Okay,
he's
but...
He's not coherent at all.
Okay, so is he... Okay, is he breathing?
Yes.
Okay, so he was injured in a car accident. Did he get treatment originally from when he was injured? Did he go to the hospital or?
No treatment at all. We're just here and he can't move.
Okay, how long ago did the accident happen though? How long, I mean, a couple of hours ago or when?
Like 20 minutes ago.
Okay, and so did it happen in front of your house?
No, not in front of our house, outside of our gated community.
Okay, but now he's inside the house with you, correct? Correct?
Yes.
Okay, the fire department's on the way. We want to keep him in a very stable position and not move him. How's his breathing doing right now?
He's okay. He's breathing.
Okay. Is there any obvious broken bones that you can tell? You see anything broken?
Just something on his back is pulling out on his spine, and that's... I'm not sure.
Okay, but there's no blood or bone or anything sticking out through there.
Not.
Okay.
No.
Is he throwing up? Any vomiting?
No vomiting.
Okay.
No,
does he look pale, cold, or sweaty to you?
No.
No? Okay. Just keep him as comfortable as you can. Not a lot of movement, okay? We'll be right there.
By the way, shout out to Chronicle Speaks from YouTube for those 911 calls. But that was it, y'all. I feel like Kevin's wife is about tired of his foolishness and his friends is too. But, you know, I kind of believe everybody's alleged, alleged theory that happened. I felt that Kevin, you know, was in the car, was driving, wasn't supposed to be driving, was driving drunk. And you know, whatever, he tore his car up. And, you know, this blase, this, and the third, and that was that. And so, yeah. But that's that. I think that's all I have for the Inside Scoop with Red segment, my portion. But here's Nina Taylor with This Week in Gospel News. And I'll be back with more of the RH3 Show, all right? Be back in a minute.
Hi, I'm Nina Taylor, and here is your gospel news. Formed in 1998 and based out of Richmond, Virginia, contemporary gospel group GEI, the name is an abbreviation for the words God's Image, is made up of four talented singers, songwriters, dancers, and musicians. Brandon Anderson on keyboards, his brother Marlon Anderson on bass, Lamonte Harris on drums, and Curtis Langley on keyboards. The group also owns and operates its own label, BGA Records, and various group members hold executive positions within the company. GI's dynamic performance have built them up a large following. The group has released several projects, including O Come All Ye Faithful in 2008, God's Image 2009, and Winning in 2011. Not long ago, this young man dreamed of stopping wide receivers in the NFL, but a high school injury ended his professional hopes. During the recovery process, God revealed to him the calling of music, which has been in his life since childhood. From his early days as a member of the Florida A&M University FAMU Gospel Choir, Choice Need continued to develop his musical talents in the industry. The FAMU Gospel Choir advisor, the late Prince J.D. Olds, recognizing Choice's leadership qualities and musical gifts, offered him the position of Minister of Music. During this season of growth, he worked, traveled with, and was mentored by renowned gospel music artists such as the Reverend J. James Cleveland, the late Thomas Whitfield, and the late Dr. Maddie Moss Clark, Twinkie Clark, LaShawn Pace, and the late Reverend James Moore. Upon receiving his degree in elementary education, Troy worked as an educator in Jacksonville, Florida. Keeping his gifts and sights on the Lord, his relationship then opened doors for another opportunity as he developed his first solo project entitled Call Jesus. The second project, Bless That Wonderful Name. And in the fall of 1998, a new course was sparked as Savoy Records and the Georgia Mass Choir presented a 400-voice youth choir entitled Youth for Christ, which was directed and produced by Troy Sneed. Troy continues to seek and obey Christ in every endeavor of his life. God continues to open windows and pour out blessings. In 2003, Troy began Intro Gospel, a gospel recording label, which has multiplied by leaps and bounds. God has allowed Troy to build a phenomenal roster, which to date includes Alvin Darling, Bonafide Praisers, Bruce Parham, and many others. From Washington, D.C., the movie Push Out, The Criminalization of Black Girls in Schools. It premiered at the Congressional Black Caucus Legislative Conference in September. The documentary examines a new and alarming trend of African-American girls are the fastest growing population in the criminal justice system, and the only group of girls disproportionately experiencing criminalization and harsh discipline at every educational level. The premiere screening was hosted by Congresswoman Ayanna Pressley and took place in Washington, D.C. at the Washington Convention Center. Here's your Billboard Top 10 Gospel Songs in the Country. Number 10, J.J. Harrison in Youthful Praise featuring Rich Talbert with Miracle Worker. Number 9, Kirk Franklin, Love Theory. Number 8, John P. Key and Zacardi Cortez with I Made It Out. Number 7, James Fortune and Deborah Carolina with I Am. 6, Jonathan McReynolds, Make Room. 5, Corinne Hawthorne, Unstoppable. Number 4, Anthony Brown and Group Therapy, Blessings on Blessings. Number 3, Tasha Cobbs-Leonard, You Know My Name. And number 2, Donald Lawrence presents the Tri-City Singers featuring Leandria Johnson with Deliver Me, This Is My Exodus. And our new number 1 song comes from Todd Delaney featuring Nicole Harris with You're Doing It All Again. Well, that's your Billboard Top 10 Songs and your Gospel News. I'm Nina Taylor, reminding you to connect with me on all social media and write me at thegospelnewswithnina@gmail.com. Until next time, let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
The 2 days that I'm on air, or each time you listen to me on your favorite podcast platform, please know that I love doing it just as much as you love listening. July 2019, the broadcast turned 4. And in January 2020, the brand will be 10. I never would have thought that I'd be here doing what I love to do for the people I love, you, my co-host, my day one family. I just give God all the glory and the honor. For you all and for the RH3 Show.
The RH3 Show every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
Does your ministry, business, or organization need a new brand? Or maybe you're looking for a graphic artist to give your letterheads, publications, or your upcoming event flyer a little more pop and eye appeal? Then Integrity Media and Design is your one-stop shop. They offer many services that will suit your needs. Services such as media production and editing,
graphic design,
business identity, and much more. That's Integrity Media and Design.
More information is available at
integritymedia.weebly.com or on Facebook, Integrity Media and Design, or you can also find them on Twitter at OfficialIMD7. Integrity Media and Design. Media and design with integrity in mind. I don't leave you.
I just told you that's how I felt. That's how I felt. If I wanted to say that, I would have wrote it.
Well, you implied that.
I said what I said. You don't like it, you don't like it.
It's the Real Talk with Red segment right here on The Arch 3 Show. All right, you guys, it is a Real Talk with Red discussion. And as you know, this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on real life topics. We also have grown folks discussion. And I want you all to listen to this clip. And it is of Fantasia and her husband, Kendall, talking about being submissive and, you know, being a wife being submissive and, you know, the whole relationship aspect or whatever. And I'll be back with more of my commentary. All right. This was, you know, blown up over the weekend, not the weekend, but over the week. And, you know, hey, some people don't like it. Some people do. And it's okay because that's your opinion. But I'll let y'all know as I stand. But here is Fantasia and Kendall Taylor. Be back in a moment.
Okay. So, we talk a lot. I just got home. He just got home. We were in New York for Fashion Week. And then he had to fly out to go speak at the prisons. And I had to continue to keep working. So, I went up to the Breakfast Club. And I enjoyed it. And
proud of you, too.
Thanks, babe. We were just wrapping it up and talking. And I was speaking. Yeah. So when I got back home, he had kind of said something that piggybacked off what I was saying. And I thought it was so dope coming from the male perspective that I felt like the male and the female should hear. So
here's the issue. Submission is supposed to be a beautiful song and dance between two lovers. What's happened is men have abused that power. Forgive me, they've abused that gift. And we have been misled to think that it's something where it's a dominant spirit and we own every decision, we dictate everything, we rule with an iron fist. First of all, that's not love.
Mm.
What happens is, in my marriage, let me not speak for everybody, my marriage, I submit daily to the Most High. I stay in my scriptures. I continue to feed myself with things that help me build my character, to reshape my perspective that was messed up in the streets and dealing with different propaganda and programming and things like that, so that I can come to my wife from a pure position.
Mm-hmm.
So when I do that and she sees me and she witnesses over time that it's an authentic demonstration, her heart is moved and softened and compelled to submit to me.
Yeah.
What does that look like? That doesn't mean that I dictate every decision. I don't walk around the house saying what we're going to spend, how we're going to do it. We talk and we build. And I consider everything that's on her heart, her perspective, her position, her philosophy. I'll carefully weave that into my philosophy to figure out what's the best move for this family, keeping all of that in mind. Now, the moment I start to step outside of righteousness and I start to move from a place of emotion instead of analytics, she has every right to snatch that back, because submission is a gift.
Mm.
When she sees me laying at the foot of the Father, she has no reason to withhold that from me.
Mm.
The problem is this. Men are not found in positions of leadership handling it with integrity. How you gonna lead your wife if you can't balance a checkbook? If you don't know what's going on in the stock market, you don't have a sound understanding of the finances, you can't create a budget, you don't understand what's going on in the educational system in your community that's impacting your kids. In order to lead, you got to be so far ahead of your family that by the time they come to you with a situation or a problem, you've already dived into it, done your due diligence so that you can give leadership.
Mm-hmm.
You don't lead from your genitals. You lead from a gentle place of understanding. And the more she trusts, the more she can let go of things that she don't have to deal with and focus on the things that edify her. It ain't about money. We both hustlers. It's not about a dollar for dollar thing, because we're one unit.
Yeah.
If I fall, she falls. If she falls, I fall. Submission is solely about trust.
I think when women hear the word submission, we're like, what?
Hey.
Submitting with my husband, like he said, to piggyback off what he just said, it was what he demonstrated. Yeah, I mean, like, he didn't come in and say, all right, like you said, we're going, the budget is this for that, this is that, and the third. I watched how he did things. I watched how he budgeted. I watched him. And then I slowly became him. And I submitted in that.
Though.
Yeah, now I think I'm more frugal than him. And that's not even being like gotta be frugal because we don't have it. It's just being smart. And the word, if you dig deep in the word with your partner, you'll start to see a lot of things that we're talking about. But yeah, I like that he broke that down, because I'm a very strong woman. I like what I like. I'm very strong. But when it comes to allowing him to cover and lead this home, I sit back and allow him to do that, and it makes me better. Wow, that light.
Lead by example.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? If you want your wife to be humble, walk in humility. If you want your wife to forgive, you be quick to forgive. If you want your wife to consider, you know, following you down a specific path, prove to her that you got the blueprint and that she's not following you to some unknown destination. My wife don't have to follow anything that she don't see me demonstrating.
Yeah.
So master the thing before you go out and try to teach it. It's like sometimes you see cats, as soon as they get a book and they read something, they start running trying to teach people on it, but you haven't applied it and gone through the proven grounds of being able to master that information yourself. So leadership is a forward-thinking thing. And when you do that, women's natural instinct is going to be to trust, to be able to submit their hearts. But again, this ain't a dominant thing.
Nah.
And I want my wife cold as me, because if something ever happens to me, she don't like having that conversation.
He always say that.
If something ever happens to me, she need to know how to get that bag. She need to understand where the money's at. She need to know how to ask the right questions. I ain't telling you to ask nobody nothing. You tell them what belongs to you. Mm-hmm. She can't do that if I'm controlling everything. So my wife needs to be a direct female reflection of the man that I am. Facts.
Come on now.
You come on.
You know, I always said the wise woman once told me, the older women used to tell me, stop, boy.
What up?
Is the woman is the neck and the man is the head. And without the neck, the head can't move.
Two heads is just a head, but see how that works. See how that works.
So, yeah. And I'm going to end it with this. We ain't perfect. We ain't trying to be perfect. We're still growing. And we just want to share that with all those out there that's still growing and want.
And get clarity. Don't be trying to twist my wife's words up at the end of the day, because I'm proud of her for standing.
They try to do that?
Man, whatever to them. At the end of the day, we want to make sure there's clarity to what she said and the understanding, and be able to hear the force behind what she is saying. So don't get tangled and twisted. It ain't for everybody. Do your thing. But for women out there who truly desire that, and men who want to step up to the call, we just want to take time out, make sure we bring clarity to our demonstration, and hope that it's fruit for you and your lives. And watch how God bless. Straight like that.
Mine.
Salute.
But yes, I totally agree with what they're saying. But it also, you know, for one, I say this often, but a woman can't lead if her husband is not doing right. A woman can't be submissive, excuse me. A woman can't be submissive if her husband not doing right. A woman can't be submissive if he's not being led by the Holy Ghost and led by God the Father. If that's the case, that whole dynamic is tore up. Vice versa, because the Bible also states, and I think in that verse 21, that says, you know, of course, man, woman, wives submit to your husband, but also said, excuse me, y'all, still dealing with this blame headache. Submit yourself one to the other. Submit yourself one to another. Submit yourself one to another. That means whoever reading is, submit yourself to your own husband. Submit yourself to your own wife. One to another. Wives, submit yourself to your husband. Da 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 da. And then have some more instructions for the wives and instructions for the husband. We all got to do what's right. But the family cannot function properly if the head is not on correctly, and you know, whatever, a wife isn't lower than her husband because he's the head of the house and God is the head of them. It works together. I don't believe in 50-50. I believe in 100-100, because it's not fair to my wife and children if I give them half of me. I'm not giving them all of me. So I have to give them all of me. I have to. Submit yourself to your own spouse. Also, another thing, people got it twisted to where men have to be the one in the house paying the bill. Of course, absolutely. Men have to be the number one head of that. They have to be. But if he is doing all this, that, and the third, and, you know, you are my help meet, what is you here for? If I'm doing all of this, I mean, you're supposed to help me out. I'm not saying help me out so I can have some money on my own. No, help me out. Help me while I'm helping you. Help me while I'm helping you. Of course, you know, back in the day, your grandfather, whoever, provided for the family, because the dynamics it was different back then. But now everything is high. We all have to get up off our tail and get ready. The only way that will work if the man is able enough to pay all of it and still not be struggling. Still not. But hey, it is what it is. You guys, I'm about to leave out of here. Know that I love you for real, and always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and love yourself and other people beyond words. For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit my website at drcshow.com. I'll see y'all on Tuesday of next week. I can't take this anymore. My head is... I'm gone. The 2 days that I'm on air, or each time you listen to me on your favorite podcast platform, please know that I love doing it just as much as you love listening. July 2019, the broadcast turned 4. And in January 2020, the brand will be 10. I never would have thought that I'd be here doing what I love to do for the people I love. You, my co-host, my day one family. I just give God all the glory and the honor for you all and for the RH3 Show.
The RH3 Show every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
Here is another Be Positive message for today. This message is for my brothers. Fellas, lead by example. If you want your family to follow the leader, if you want your family to do what's right in the community, if you want your family to do what's right amongst each other, if you want your sons and your daughters to do what's right amongst their friends, their girlfriends, boyfriends, whoever they are trying to see, fellas, lead by example. For your sons, if you want them to treat women right, lead by example. Treat your wife right. Treat your girlfriend right. Lead by example. If you want your children to do what's right in church, lead by example. If you want your daughters to find men who protect them and cherish them, lead by example. Protect and cherish their mother. Protect and cherish them. If you want your children to do what's right in the community, lead by example. Go and coach little league teams. Go and coach youth softball teams. Do whatever you can do, fathers. Do whatever you can do, men. Lead by example. Do what's right in the church. Do what's right in the home. Do what's right in the community. And I bet you, your family will follow the leader.
The RH3 Show every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
This portion of the RH3 Show is a best of highlighted moment. Whatever, Andrew, come on. Y'all, I'm sorry, I had to watch a preview of, not a preview, but a pre-recorded IG Live of Andrew Caldwell. And so this dude is... His quote been delivered, quote. Quote, been delivered, quote. So let me finish eating on air, because y'all, this salad is good, but I don't know. I mean, with me and salads, it's kind of sometimes my body take it well, sometimes it just get queasy or whatever. And so, hey, it is what it is. Okay, anyway, we're back. If you, in case you didn't notice for the past minute, it is the RST Show. If you're just now joining me, we are in another, we're stretching this segment. We're just stretching it, y'all, stretching it. Y'all, before the health minute, I was talking about my crush, y'all. I really do like this chick, y'all. She's bad. But, you know, y'all hit me up. Look, I need y'all advice. I give y'all ask for my advice, and I need y'all advice. So, if you will, you can inbox me on the RH3 Show on Facebook or Instagram. But how, how can you prevent or stop one, a female, of course, ladies, you know, how can us men get out of that bruh phase for you? Look. I just be wanting to say, come on, sis. Come on. I don't call her sis. I call her by her name, but I'm like, come on. You know, I'm like, every time I talk, okay, thank you, bro. And look, I know we brothers and sisters in Christ, but still, I'm trying to holler. And that just, that is kind of a turnoff. Fellas, you get what I'm saying? Anyway, let's move on because we got a jam-packed show and I am wasting time here. I'm wasting time. And so, y'all, hashtag ask Red on IG. When I do in my Insta stories or whatever, respond, because, you know, hey, I want some interaction with you all. And so, please, that's new of the new season is, the Ask Red on IG. And so, you know, you submit an anonymous question and I answer it or whatever. All right. And, y'all, speaking of, friendships or whatever, we weren't talking about it, but I need to inject it. Friends. How many of us have them? Friends. Folks you can depend on. Let's be friends. Y'all, when I tell you, or if you do not know, a friend, if a person makes me feel good about myself. Hold on a second. What is y'all doing? Anyway, if a person makes me feel good about myself because of what they said, or let me rephrase that. What you say to me, how did I read that this morning? What you say, or how your words and how you make somebody feel determine the type of person that you are. If you say something and make somebody feel really good, that makes you a good person. That makes you a good person. And so, y'all, I thank God for real good friends. And so, in probably about a week or so, I'm going to, you know, pay homage to some great, you know, I don't know why I said some, because I really don't have none, you know, really good, close, tight, that I could just say, really good friends, good friends, you know, that's really there for me, there. And so, you know, they really have my back and this, that, and the third, and, you know, some of them have my back because of familiarity, or some of them have my back because of not only familiarity, but some of them have my back because of common interest, and you know, because I scratch your back, you scratch mine. Of course, that's supposed to, you know, be amongst us all. But But sometimes, sometimes there can be a point in our lives to where I can surprisingly scratch your back and you not even ask for it. I can surprisingly, you know, do something for you and you know, you not even ask for it. That is called pouring back into friends. That is pouring back into friends. And I will say this, even if I don't do that show, or if I somehow, air quotes, forget, I will say this without even saying any names. I have two that really unashamedly out in public, in open, amongst crowds, friends, amongst people, do not mind saying kind things to your boy. It never fails. And those who know me in real life and who are listening to me, my finger is up in the air in front of my face saying, pointing to this mic, it's not who you think. Well, one of them is, but the other one, not who you think. You know, because the reason why I say that is because I mean, of course I have some really good friends and yeah, they do good stuff for me, but these two here, you know, y'all, no matter the type of person I am, no matter what I do for people, no matter the type, you know, what I say, do, how much I'm there, if you don't have, and that's just like a regular dating relationship, if he or she is not pouring back into you, what is the reason for that relationship? What is it? I mean, come on, let me know. It doesn't matter. Best friends, homies, you know, courting, dating, boyfriend and girlfriend, husband and wife. Even with husband and wife, when they not pouring back into you, y'all gonna have to, you know, get some counseling, because, you know, sooner or later might be doomed for, you know, whatever. You have to pour back into a relationship that you're in. Godly relationship between you and God. God, you have to be there. You have to pour back into each other. God is always doing that for us. We have to love on him as well. If we have a friend, whether if it's a homeboy or ladies, if it's one of your girlfriends or, you know, sisters or whatever you call her, and fellas, if it's one of your homies, if it's a female friend, if they are pouring into you, pour back into them. Pour back into them. And I'm the type of person that I may say I don't, whatever. And even we have to learn our friends' love language, right? We have to learn our friends' love language, because that love language goes, you know, it reaches to every area of our lives, whether if it's, you know, a friendship, and y'all know I get to rambling and talking and, you know, whatever, and hey, I hope I can get the real talk with real discussion in, and hopefully this just may be it, but, I'm gonna squeeze it in, but, it reaches, and so whatever my love language is, my girlfriend has to know it, my homie has to know it, or whatever, because, you know, and one friend of mine, you know, may not like me to tell homie, I appreciate you, this, that, and the third, you my dog, and I thank you, whatever. You know, he may not like that, but he may like, you know, spend quality time, oh, let's go out here and play ball, or let's do this, or let's do that, or, you know, this, that, and the third, let's just hang out. that might be his, you know, the way to hang out with you. I mean, come on. We have to know when to pour back into our friends. We have to. And whenever I say a friend of mine did that this, I think it was the past weekend. What I needed and on time. Why? Is because some underhanded stuff happened. But you know what? It happens so frequently. It just really did not. It does not faze me anymore. And so I'm like, okay, you know what? I don't even know. You know, I believed it the last time, but I thought that it wasn't going to happen again. And sure enough, it is. You know. And so, you know, hey, we have to know and learn and understand that whenever somebody show you who they are, believe them. Whenever they show you who they are, believe them. Right? Whenever they show you who you are, who they are, believe them. Whenever they show you who they are, believe them. Because look, if me and you have something, you know, planned or whatever, and I see something the same thing, and then I'm like, you know what, hey, me and such, you want to go hang out with us on Friday, nah, because I had something planned with such and such, and I can't even do that, you know, I can't leave them behind like that. And if, you know, if I say, well, okay, whatever, this, that, and the third, and then you know, I a couple hours later, hey, you know, Johnny, for instance, hey, Johnny, man, on Friday, I'm going to hang out with Sessa. Well, didn't you just tell me the other day that, you know, next time it going, you know, you get a free time, you're going to come hang out with me and this, that, and the third, or next time, you know, we get the opportunity to go here, you was going to, you know, we was going to whatever. Why you didn't tell, you know, such and such that was going to take place and know you didn't want to, you know, chill with them? You took the first thing smoking and just left me behind. I can't do that. I can't, y'all. I still love each and every one of my homies with everything in me. But my mindset and my thought pattern with each and every friendship is going to have to change. And I'm talking to myself, y'all, because, you know, hey, and whoever listening to this, if you're listening to it and you feel like it's for you, wear it, because, you know, hey, it's time out for letting people, you know, depending on folks, and I say this often, you got to stop depending on people and start depending on yourself. You got to stop depending on people to do stuff for you. Stop it, y'all. It is very hard for me to say that. Why? I'm glad you asked why, because I don't drive, and, you know, hey, I don't drive, and, I don't drive, and whenever I do, want to go someplace, I can't go nowhere far distance, because, you know, I don't drive, and I'm gonna have to catch, okay, you know, ask for, look, I have to, you know, throw it, and I hate to keep telling this to people, but if I have to constantly tell you, look, hey, if we friends or whatever, and if I have to keep telling you, hey, just let me know when you're going such and such, because I don't drive, I don't have the opportunity to go this, that, and the third, unless it's around the city and public transportation or whatever, just let me know. If I have to continue to do that, then hey, you don't know me like you think you know me, you know? This may be a cry and a pour out, but y'all, when are we going to find somebody that's really genuine for us? When? And it really, you know, and I hate that I'm getting, you know, and look, if y'all new to this show, y'all know I show all types of emotions, happiness, angriness, sadness, crying, or whatever. But, you know, hey, when? Because, you know, hey, look, it's time out for beating the dead horse and you know, whatever. Because it is, y'all, it is what it is, people. It is what it is. It is what it is. If folks gonna do it, they're gonna do it. If they're not, you know, whatever. But when you have one, at least one or two people to celebrate you in front of a you know, whatever, hey, it is what it is. I miss them, folks. I miss them. And I miss, you know, being around, you know, folks that really care and pour back into you. Come on. Okay, let me stop. Let me stop. Let me toughen up, man up. Hey, family. It is the closing of today's broadcast. I am sorry that I had to leave early. Whatever it was, I had to do what I had to do. But for more about me or the broadcast, you can visit my website at theirishthreeshow.com. I'll see y'all when I see y'all. Maybe tomorrow, maybe the next day, whatever. But until then, check me out on my website, theirishthreeshow.com. And as I say at the end of each broadcast, end of each video, whatever I do, know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, to love yourself and other people beyond words. I'll see you soon. Peace.
See you later.
I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night. Good night.